Hi, this is Rory Raye, and this is a series on online dating and all the ins and outs and the imperfections and the frustrations and all of it. So I want you to feel better, and I want you to have fun with circular dating and using online as a way to do it. And so I'm happy to answer your questions in the comments and to show you to articles where you can actually read this and feel better about the whole thing, because it's glorious practice, glorious training. It's just glorious because it's inner work without going and showing up at a therapist's office. It is self-coaching. And if you want to get into even all more details, you know my modern siren programs will give you the tools. So you take your tools and you go out there and you practice them with real men in the field, okay? So what I want to talk about here is what I started in one of the other videos, which is the feeling of rejection and a void when somebody ghosts you or somebody disappears or there's radio silence. You know, you think you've got a live one and then there's radio silence. And I want to talk about this as the difference between rejection and disappointment. Yeah, I feel disappointed. I was hoping my time in online training was over, right? You're just hoping it's over, but it's not over. It's never really gonna be over. I want you to circular date your whole life, even after you're married and have kids and whatever it is you want, you know, or traveling the world with your guy. I still want you to feel that you can be open with other men everywhere. It just makes everything feel so much better. It makes him feel more alive. It's awesome. So circular dating itself is a tool you want to learn to practice. And it's about free therapy, and it's about learning you. It's about learning how you are with men at different stages of knowing them. So when you first meet somebody just in writing online, it's weird. You can't really interpret what he's saying, because just like in a text, the voice means nothing. It's like we make stuff up. So after a while, if he just disappears, we start making more stuff up, right? Oh, he didn't like the way I looked. Oh, he didn't like the sound of my voice. Oh, something was wrong. And we take it personally. Or we go, oh, I'm not going to take it personally, and we just kind of shove it aside. Well, we know that's just a defensive reaction. Yeah, it hurts when somebody turns their back to us, hangs up, turns their back. It hurts. And I want you to feel that hurt. I want you to feel and experience the weirdness of having somebody just say goodbye to you, somebody you didn't even know. And then the frustration and the anger that you spend any time on it at all. And I want you to kind of put that all together. Maybe you could write it down. You know, send the letter to me, you know, I'll print it on the blog. Awesome. The whole idea of it is there is no such thing as an easy path, smooth path to anything that's really worthwhile. Really, getting the training you need for a really top level job, I mean, there's ups and downs, right? Not everything is golden. In a relationship, in a marriage, trust me, not everything is golden, because we have to continue to work stuff out in order to grow. And being in a relationship is helpful for many reasons. It's fun, it's wonderful, it's satisfying, love is great, but it's also triggering constantly. You are constantly being triggered and asked to grow. Meaning you're asked to not react with upset. You're asked to look at the other person and go, where's that? Where are you coming from? Oh, well, I wonder what made you say that. And this feels icky at the same time. So this is a lot, right? You can't just do it from watching my programs. You got to practice it. That's why it's so important to practice circular dating and really keeping track. In Targeting Mr. Right, there's a whole spreadsheet. Go ahead, use it. print it out and you write down the name of the guy and what happened and what tools of mine you practiced. That is going to help you tremendously, because all of a sudden it's a scientific experiment. It's not trying to get a guy, right? When your energy is trying to get a guy, everything feels bad. If it's like, oh, that was an experiment. How interesting. You know, he just disappeared. Wow. Well, that is proof that he wasn't for me. And the way you begin to take it in, feeling first the frustration and the hurt and whatever pain you feel when somebody disappears, it will shift after you've done it enough times. So the guy is doing you a big favor by getting out of the game before you are invested in any way, without wasting one more phone call, one more text. I know that you know the experience and your girlfriends who get hung up in a relationship that isn't even a relationship. It's like the start of something, and they already feel invested and attracted, and that's not what I want for you. I want you just to take the attitude of training. It's weird to think of training in love, right? But it is. And guess what? It's self-training. You are learning to go through all these experiences, feel all these yicky feelings, and feel the fun feelings too, and see if they start to shift as you spend more time practicing and writing it down and developing a philosophy for yourself about how this is going, and never losing sight of what it is you want in the end, right? Love, a great relationship, a great partner. So somebody who is not there 100%, not a great partner. Bye. The attraction that you are creating will automatically eliminate him. He can feel that. Bye. Right? And when you learn how to speak what it is you want and how you feel in a way that feels relaxing and serene and sireny to you, and yet warm and respectful to him, why would you want to attract all those wrong guys? Too many guys on the playing field. There are going to be so many men on the playing field for you. So many men who want to be around you once you really feel yourself into the training and you don't feel batted around so much by these feelings of rejection and hurt. But first thing you got to do is feel it. Maybe write it down. Write poems to yourself about, wow. And really ask yourself, did I put too much energy into this? Is that why I'm feeling it? Remember, anger is in direct proportion to the energy you have put out. That's the way it goes in relationship. Anger is in direct proportion to the energy you have given to him. So if you don't give energy, but you just go, hey, he showed up and nothing, and you just smile at him, and then he disappears, you're not going to feel so bad. Right? So this is what the training is, to not invest, just to have fun at the level that feels right to you, but always with the depth of your own feelings. So write to me in the comments and I'll get back to you. We'll send you links to articles that will answer your question, because there's so many articles. And I really look forward to hearing from you, talking with you, and also let me know what you'd like me to talk about, because that's what these are all about. To get more relationship advice, check out this video next.